Hello friends, this is Jennifer Terry and welcome to my channel. In this video, we'll talk about the latest travel advisory of the Bureau of Immigration entitled Arrival Travel Restrictions in the Philippines. So to cut it short, there's nothing new about this travel advisory, but what I like about this one is that it sums up all the press release and the announcement we've been getting since middle of February. So it sums up everything and puts it in one piece so that, you know, every one of us are on the same page. So let's have a read. All right, so the travel advisory starts with the most important question: who are allowed to enter the Philippines? So obviously the first up on the list are Filipino citizens. This includes dual Filipino citizens. Next up are balikbayans. So in this term, they are referring to Filipino citizens, foreign spouses, and children, regardless of age, who are traveling with their Filipino family member. And then former Filipino citizens, including their spouse and children, regardless of age, who are traveling with them. And just a reminder that not all those I've mentioned are covered by the balikbayan privilege, by the one-year visa-free stay in the Philippines, right? So if you are holding a citizenship of any of these countries, you will still need a visa to enter the Philippines, even if you are a former Filipino. The thing is, these countries, they are visa required. These are not visa-free countries, okay? Anyway, let's keep going. And lastly on the list on who is allowed to enter the Philippines are all foreign nationals with valid and existing visas. So we don't have to go through each visa. Simple. All foreign nationals with valid and existing visas at the time of entry to the Philippines are now allowed to enter the Philippines since February 16. Say they lifted the restrictions for all foreign nationals with valid and existing visas. And on the other hand, the travel exemption or DFA endorsement is still required. So that requirement is still there. And who needs it? The DFA endorsement or the entry exemption is required for those holding 9A visas under CA613 and those holding SRRVs or special retiree or special resident and retirees visa. So these two groups still need to secure an entry exemption. So contact the Philippine Embassy in your area to get this exemption. And for SRRVs, I posted the process on my community tab, or you may visit Philippine Retirement Agency on Facebook. They put down the process there. Not all 9A visa holders need a DFA endorsement or an entry exemption. So exempted from this DFA endorsement requirement are immediate families of Filipinos holding 9A visas. And for those arriving non-immigrant and immigrant visa holders issued by the Bureau of Immigration, remember to bring your valid re-entry permits or valid special return certificate. But don't worry, if yours has expired already, that's okay. The Bureau of Immigration already clarified in a press release that for those holding expired RPs and SRCs, you may renew it at the airport when you arrive. You just have to pay for the fees. All right. And additionally, all foreign nationals entering the Philippines need a pre-booked quarantine hotel for 6 nights. Okay? 6 nights. Everyone except 9E diplomats, 9E visa holders don't need the pre-booked quarantine. And the Bureau of Immigration warned that those who fail to present a pre-booked accommodation shall be denied entry and shall be boarded immediately onto the next available flight. That's pretty harsh, isn't it? On the other hand, the outbound rules hasn't changed, okay? Since October when it was lifted, it stayed like that. Nothing changed. So Filipinos are allowed to travel overseas even for tourism. But there are requirements, of course, and the requirements are still the same. So Filipinos on tourist visas need a confirmed round trip tickets and then a travel and health insurance to cover travel disruptions and hospitalization in case of COVID-19 infection, and an execution of a Bureau of Immigration form acknowledging risk of travel. And then whenever required by the country of destination or the airlines, a negative COVID result taken in accordance with the health and safety protocols of such country of destination or airline. And Filipinos coming back to the Philippines who left the country for tourism would still undergo the same protocols. Just like everyone else, you'd undergo the same protocols. And that is, you know, quarantine in a hotel. On the sixth day, undergo the COVID testing. It's the same. Meanwhile, on a press release that was announced today, the Bureau of Immigration told the public that they will order a stricter screening of aliens with temporary visitor visas. So a memorandum order issued recently by the Commissioner Jaime Morente reminded immigration inspectors manning the ports to conduct strict arrival formalities on arriving passengers despite having the required documents. And we know that the 9A visa is not just issued for immediate families of Filipinos, but they were also issued for people with very essential need to travel to the Philippines. For example, foreign workers, foreign students whose visa has already expired, they were given 9A visas so they could enter the Philippines. This press release today is just a reminder that if you are a 9A visa holder, you need to support or back up your claims while you are entering the Philippines. You need to bring your supporting documents, and when they ask you questions, you should be able to answer. Simple question, why are you traveling to the Philippines? If you are a genuine traveler, you should be able to do that easy. So this order of a stricter screening of aliens with temporary visitor visas is stemmed from last month's interception of several Chinese nationals who arrived in the country with entry visas, with entry exemption, who turned out to have misrepresented their purpose in traveling to the Philippines. So when these several Chinese nationals were questioned, why are you traveling to the Philippines? What's your role in these companies? Stuff like that. They asked them questions. They were not able to establish their connection with the companies that invited them to visit the Philippines. And they gave inconsistent answers. Thus, they were denied entry. So 9A visa holders holding entry exemptions, be prepared. Explain your purpose of traveling to the Philippines. Bring supporting documents. Stand firm. So that is all for this Bureau of Immigration travel advisory and press release, friends. I mean, nothing's new, but everything's been summed up, and we're just being warned, especially 9A visa holders with entry exemptions. Philippines is really strict. You know, this stems from corruption.